In 1968, the crew of Apollo 8 became the first people to ever orbit the moon. While doing so, this happened.
Alright, we're gonna roll. Ready? Just prior to the subsolar point on the south side and the floor of it, oh my god, look at that picture over there. There's the coming up. Wow, that's pretty. Hand me a roll of color quick.
Oh man, that's great.
Where is it? Quick. Hey, calm down, Mama. Oh, that's a beautiful shot.
Little did they know, but what the crew of Apollo 8 saw that moment changed their lives forever. And that same thing has also changed the lives of any other astronaut who's been to space to witness it. This is the story of a sight so radical, it causes an immediate cognitive shift that changes the lives and perspective of its spectators forever. And to understand what makes it so powerful, we first need to talk about Christopher Waltz's acting technique?
Ooh, that's a bingo!
Tell me, Aldo, if I were sitting where you're sitting, would you show me mercy? Nope.
The acting method Christopher Waltz practices is called the Meisner technique. According to it, actors need to get out of their heads and act instinctively, through emotion, to their surroundings, to fully live and immerse themselves in the moment. So, what does it have to do with space? Nothing. But the intensity of this sight in space can truly be experienced only when witnessing it in space. And from here on Earth, watching a video, practically impossible to really feel it. The only way we can somehow apprehend the impact of that sight is to practice the Meisner technique ourselves, to immerse ourselves intellectually and emotionally in the experience of an astronaut. I want to ask you for just a couple of minutes to leave everything aside, have a seat, pop your earphones in, and try to really feel the following. After 68 hours of travel, you become one of the first three people in the world to ever orbit the moon. You are taking part in what is, undoubtedly, one of humanity's greatest achievements ever. And the eyes of the entire people of planet Earth are literally looking up to you. Only 24 people in history will have gone as far as you are now, an infinitesimal percentage of the planet's population. And you are part of that elite, one of the most exclusive minorities in the world. It's Christmas Eve back on Earth, but out here in this immeasurable and dark void that is space, it's quiet. Quiet as you've never heard before. Sound results from our ears detecting vibrations in the air. Since space is a vacuum, you're continuously hearing it. Almost nothing. You've been constantly hovering, drifting afloat. Astronaut Sandra Magnus once said, "All of us understand what gravity is, but I would argue strongly that you have no idea what gravity is until you've left it, come back, and experienced that horrible force trying to push you into the ground." Feeling this intoxicating sensation for 3 days now, you understand exactly what she meant. 3 days. On Earth, people measure days based on the rotation of the planet causing sunrise and sunset. But out here in space, there are no such things anymore. There is no more meaning to hours or minutes or day or night. In space, there is no time. What are those 3 days exactly? You're not sure anymore. What you do know is that every wrong move, every wrong decision you make is fatal. But you've worked tremendously hard in the past 2 years, physically and mentally, to meet your mission around the moon with as little mistakes as possible. 2 whole years of preparations and anticipation for this moment, now. And then, something happens. In this metaphysical, yet indefinitely absolute experience, all of a sudden something appears in front of you. It's, in fact, the most obvious and trivial sight. You knew you were going to see it. But in actuality, nothing could have prepared you to witness it this way. Witness it with your own eyes.
Oh my God, look at that picture over there. There's the Earth coming up. Wow, that's pretty. Hand me a roll of color quick.
Oh man, that's great.
Where is it? Quick. Hey, don't take that. It's not scheduled. Anything, quick. Oh, I got it right. Oh, that's a beautiful shot.
The radical sight astronauts see in space that literally changes their lives is home. Not the boundless cities and colossal mountains we know it as from within, but a floating marble, Earth in its fullness, right there in front of your eyes. Over and over, one after the other, astronauts testify of the striking effects seeing Earth from space had on them. They don't only talk about how majestically beautiful it is, but they mainly stress a certain emotional and cognitive shift they experienced because of it. A newfound realization about life and our place in the greater scheme of things. This strange phenomena has a name. It's called the overview effect. But to understand what is exactly the change they experience, we first need to go a bit deeper into what you actually see when you see Earth from space. Let's head back out there. When seeing Earth from space, the first thing you notice is how alive this orb is. In a matter of minutes, you move from the deserts of Africa to the forests of South America. You see the northern lights dancing, clouds forming, lightning strikes, cities switch on and then off. The entire natural spectacle that is our home is continuously altering in front of your eyes. From space, Earth is no longer this intangible term to describe the still surroundings around us. From space, you realize Earth is its own entity, an ever-changing, ever-evolving organism. Another thing you can see only in space is how small Earth is. Everything you've ever heard, everyone you've ever known, everything can be covered behind your thumb. Seeing Earth like that, in all of its miniature glory, makes you fiercely internalize one thing. This tiny thing is so fragile. The last thing you see is not about Earth per se, but the setting in which Earth is in. It's floating, on its own, in the middle of a darkness so vast we cannot even begin to comprehend. There is nothing, nothing around it. And that inevitably strikes the understanding that Earth is entirely alone. So, what internal change does this all lead to? This is what I gathered is the best way to describe it. Observing Earth so alive, so tiny and fragile and lonely, makes us perceive our planet for the first time in history, from a perspective that had never been realized before. We understand that Earth is like a baby, a tiny, vulnerable infant that has no one else but us to take care of it. This striking and immediate understanding astronauts experience instills in them what I would see as a deep parental concern towards it. Astronauts testify returning to Earth with a profound sense of responsibility towards this lonely, tiny, fragile thing. They are determined to take care of it, to make the lives of all of Earth's inhabitants better, and to make the life of Earth itself better. From space, astronauts see more than anyone the interconnection of all life. There are no borders or pieces of land that belong to one group or another, but one unified home for all. The overview effect, in fact, has such a powerful influence over them that books have been written about it and psychological studies have attempted to explain it. Astronauts constantly go out and do talks trying to convey the feelings, and NGOs have even opened up with the sole aim of bringing people out into space so that they experience it for themselves. Besides having children, there's probably no other single experience in existence so instantaneously powerful, striking, and life-changing as the overview effect. But then I stumbled upon this picture. This picture was taken from the International Space Station in August of 2011. There's a saying that from space you can't see political borders, but this picture shows that, technically speaking, that saying is not true. This line right here is the border between India and Pakistan, illuminated by floodlights. As opposed to common belief, space actually shows us, clearer than anywhere else, our divisions. And not only between ourselves, but with nature as well. These scars Earth carries are the result of our doings. In the perspective of the overview effect, these are the times we mistreated this baby. But it's precisely when seeing these scars so clearly on the backdrop of a one consolidated Earth that we can understand the shift in perspective that's needed. Because just like a baby who has lungs and liver and heart and brain, all those separate parts that look different and act different but must work together as one system to be sustainable, so do we. The different people of different countries, of different ethnicities of planet Earth must all learn to work together, despite our differences, and not keep each other apart, to be able to thrive. And it must start, first and foremost, with changing our perspective of one another and ourselves to a more complete, overviewed angle. What do you think? What are some ways we can come closer to someone who's different? Or how do we even overcome differences? Let me know in the comments, and if you enjoyed or found value in this video, please also don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel with the small bell notification to be notified when the next video is coming out. Be deeper. Hi everyone. This was the third video in a three-part series of reflections about outer space. You can click the two thumbnails on screen now to watch the other two.